He'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three.
Brought down at the 23-yard line. A three-yard pickup brings up second and seven.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five.
And it's third down.
Brady going to throw. This is caught. Gronkowski. Brady. He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Tom Brady to his old Patriot pal, Rob Gronkowski. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, as one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
And he knocks it through. So that drive in total, eight plays. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. This will be fielded inside the five. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Getting set to go again here on offense, Keenan Allen marches back onto the field. He's hoping to take what has been a good game here and make it a great game. So far, solid, and we're still in the third quarter.
There's nothing wrong with solid. You want to be that. You want to be reliable. You want to be a guy that puts your team in a position to have a chance to win. And that's what we're seeing from him. And there's also that added element that maybe it can become a little bit more as this game goes on.
He'll try to make it more here on this drive. On first and 10, Herbert looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Herbert's pass thrown to the sideline and incomplete. It's now second and 10.
Second and 10 now from the 27. To throw again, Herbert. Dancing to his left. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
It's a gain of six. Makes it third and four.
Operating from the gun, Herbert. Flushed out right. Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
Running on first down, Eckler. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Well, if you like the guys who run the ball, you're enjoying watching this. But the other guys, especially the defense coordinator, trying to figure out an answer on how to slow down the running game, I think maybe starts to call more blitzes, because you can call run blitzes in order to try and get more people to the point of attack.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Shaquille Barrett picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Loss of 9 on the play. Brings up third down.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun. And this is going to be incomplete.
Intended for number 15. Incomplete. Results in a fourth down.
Here's Ty Long now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and that will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And that last touchdown drive, a good mix of pass and run. Defensively, they just looked a little out of whack.
And it's so hard to stay up with an offense that has things going so well, where you're guessing and guessing wrong play after play. So what you need is someone on the defensive side of the ball,
a leader, right,
to make a big play.
Yeah.
Throw that balance out of whack. That's what you're looking for now. Not worrying so much about guessing what the play call is.
Brady now on first down. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. A gain of 6 there on first.
Complete to Chris Godwin. A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4 at the 29-yard line.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Here's Brady to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Evans. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. A gain there of 21 yards.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Midfield, here's Brady. Open man, Gronkowski complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. So, 1st and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Brady to throw again. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. 2nd down.
I don't know about you, but I wanted to reach out of the booth and snatch that pass myself. That thing floated forever up there. I think that threw off the timing of the receiver. That's why he couldn't get his feet down, even though he caught the ball.
You know, Charles, I would have liked to have seen that.
Yeah, me too.
For you, I wanted to see you reach out and catch that.
Yeah, you've heard about my hands, huh?
Brady's throw there complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Down.
A second down completion got him seven. Now here's third and three. Again, it's Brady. And he can't quite pick it. No interception so far. That probably should have been their first. But at least it's fourth down.
I think it's pretty safe to say that when you're up three touchdowns, the last thing you want to do is hang one up there and put it in jeopardy and possibly get it intercepted. You got a nice lead. You should be able to protect it. But if you get careless with the football, look out.
On fourth down, Ryan Succop now for the Buccaneer field goal. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And that will extend the lead out to 24.
Chargers 14.
So that's a seven-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
Yeah, things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to the goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
Now to kick this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
L.A. readies for its next possession. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
I mean, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working.
Eckler, the ball carrier.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now it's Herbert. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down.
You know they wanted. You know they expected. They needed him to be sharp coming out after the half. Unfortunately, he's missed his first three throws. I wonder if he got out late and missed his warm-up time.
The whole team did come out a little bit later than usual. I don't know. Maybe there's something to that.
Must have been a heck of a halftime speech.
Yeah, maybe. Just trying to rally the troops back from this deficit. That's into the hands of Eckler. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down.
39-yard line.
The gun, Herbert. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. Herbert, they'll contain him to just four. Second down.
A gain of four. It's now second and six at the 43-yard line.
Herbert back to the air. Over the middle, complete. That's Williams. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
The 46-yard line.
Again, Herbert. And right side, Henry's got it. A gain of six there on first.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four at the 40-yard line.
They'll come up on a second and four now from the 40-yard line. Herbert throwing again. Forced out to his left. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Maybe not exactly what they had in mind, but that scramble good for six and a first down.
But Charles, in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden. And they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense. And now, as a defensive coordinator, you've got some extra work to do to prepare for him and their offense.
Still first down.
A false start backs him up five. First and 15. A shotgun snap for Herbert. Looking for Allen. He's got him on the slam. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
Gain of 10 brings up second and five at the Buccaneers' 29-yard line.
Here's Herbert now on second down. This complete to Henry over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Well, they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Operating from the gun. Herbert, this will be caught at about the 5. 4.
Gain of 5.
That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
At the 4-yard line.
Going on the ground with Eckler. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. Kelly, they try to punch it in. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Chargers are able to close the gap just a bit. Sometimes a group that gets overlooked, certainly, the offensive line. Right there, they really helped with that score.
Didn't they tell us in our meeting that when we score touchdowns, running the ball, that means the offensive line actually scored first by moving people back beyond the end zone. We saw evidence of that on that play.
No real hesitation from Anthony Lynn. They're going to go for two. From the gun, Herbert. And they're going to get the two-point conversion, caught in the end zone. Cuts the lead a bit further. But it's still an uphill battle from here, that's for sure. But that makes it a two-score game.
And now we see why teams practice so much on the two-point conversion, why you have more than one play ready. Because you may need multiples throughout a ball game. There's a great example right there.
Kick it away following the touchdown. Taking it about the one. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. He has been on his A game. We're in the third quarter. He's already in search of touchdown pass number 5.
He's played so well that it's hard for me to take my eyes off of him, even when he's not on the field. I keep finding my eyes finding him on the bench in between series, wondering what he's going to do next. This has been a blast to watch him play the position.
Yeah, he's been spectacular with those 4 touchdown passes. Brady now on first down. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32. 7 yards to pick up there.
Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 32-yard line.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Throwing now is Brady. He gets it in the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
It's so important to tackle well against these guys, but you and I both know that's easier said than done when the guy you're trying to tackle looks like this guy.
And it's usually going to take more than one man to get him down, and it did right there. So from Charger territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 41. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37.
They
give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
4 yards on the pickup. 2nd and 6 at the 37-yard line.
Going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the 37, they work on 2nd and 6. The gun, it's Brady. That's complete to his running back Evans. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
1st down, Tampa Bay.
Now a handoff here to his running back. 5.
The tackle by Kenneth Murray. A gain of 5 brings up 2nd and 5 at the 25-yard line.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up 2nd down. And he'll give it here to his running back. Powers through. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A gain of 13, it's a 1st down.
Well, you know me, partner, I never tell them to back off of being aggressive, but sometimes you see the consequences when you're overly aggressive and you don't secure tackles. Guys break through.
Trying to sell out to pry that football loose, and just as you said, cost some yardage.
Yeah, you got to go get him. Stand him up first before you go for the ball. Don't just go for it initially.
From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. Now Brady. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown.
Brady's pass.
Tom Brady to his old Patriot pal, Rob Gronkowski. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his 2nd touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Extra point try now for Succop. AT&T pushes the lead up to 23 now. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And able to get this out to the
at their own 25-yard line.
Chargers offense back onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And he'll throw right away. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Henry. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. Back to throw here, Herbert. Trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker, and he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Now a handoff looking right. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. But the converse is, though, you've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. To throw is Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36.
Brings up third down.
So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
Let's go ahead and try and get to the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys, because the offensive guys always taught, find the first down sticks and make the play. Well, on defense, what do you want to do? Guard the first down line. Make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They were able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
45, Chargers 22.
The attack attention shifts back to Justin Herbert and the Chargers offense. And that interception that ended their previous drive likely also ended any shot they had a victory.
Yeah, long road back from here, no doubt about that one. But let's face it, if you're going to go out there and compete, you want to try and end on a strong note, don't you?
Absolutely. It won't end in a victory, like you said, but they can maybe take something positive out of this one. Herbert and the Chargers now with a first and 10 at their own 43. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. Over the middle, it's complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete.
That's good for a charge.
15 more yards there, and quickly another first down.
First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Operating from the gun, Herbert. Eluding, and he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Shaquille Barrett getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Justin Herbert looking to throw on second down. He'll get this to Eckler. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Trying to punch it in with Eckler. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Chargers, they're able to cut into that deficit. When you talk about a battle being won in the trenches, that touchdown right there, a lot of credit to the offensive linemen.
Yeah, when you watch them surge across the front, they really created great space for the runner to get in.
Charger offense will stay on the field as they'll line up to go for the 2-point try. Justin Herbert looking to pass to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Good. That keeps the score. Buccaneers 45.
Popular down near the goal line. Quick slant. Nice job there to get in, knock it away.
It was. One of the other things you're concerned about when you throw that route is to make sure your offensive linemen use their leverage to get the hands of the defensive front down so you can throw it through that little bit of crowd and get it to the receiver. In this event, they did, but a nice play by the defender knocking it away.
The city like the championships. All our records go hard. It's a champion hit.
it away following the touchdown. This will be fielded inside the five. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Back now comes Tampa Bay. Up with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Gonna give this time to the tailback. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That one 28 yards on the ground. They went with a nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that, the nickel look. 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then? You take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you're taking a big off for a little. And oftentimes you can run the football effectively against that defense.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he takes it down to the 40 with a pickup of four.
The ball carried by number two. The tackle made by Joey Bosa. A gain of four. It's now second and six at the Chargers' 40-yard line.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers' 32. A gain of four last play. They double that here and get eight.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
He's tackled at the 27-yard line. It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers' 20-yard line. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
They're certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one. And oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. But in this case, is the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter?
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Throwing again, Brady looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Sam shed a nice tackle on that play. And the Buccaneers Buccaneers are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on third and two. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
It's a nice job hitting him on the angle route there, coming out of the backfield, cutting sharply across the middle. And that's good timing between the quarterback and his receiver.
Effective third down play to move the chains. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown run as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And he's gone 2-2 on us now at 2 receiving touchdowns, now his second rushing touchdown.
And that's the back of the NFL nowadays, isn't it? The ability to do everything. You can't just be one or the other. The best ones able to run it, catch it, and produce. Big time points put on the board by him.
Suck up for the extra point. After. And the lead is now 24. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Taken in at the 3. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. Going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He'll set up to throw from the gun. Herbert has it knocked free. But a Chargers player was able to fall on it, and they'll keep possession.
We always hear a lot of veterans on the defensive side of the football. They talk about smelling blood in the water, putting pressure on a rookie. They got to him there to force it free, but couldn't recover it.
And you mentioned the pressure. Rookie quarterback, you're going to bring more pressure at him at all times because you don't know how he's going to hold up. He was fortunate there. Luck was on his side, able to recover that fumble.
The fumble on first down, now here's second down. From the gun, Herbert. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
Lead to Austin Eckler. That's a gain of 5. Brings up third and 11.
Going to throw on third down with Herbert. He's got a man. It's Williams. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A Charger first. There's Herbert finds Williams.
All right, let's just go ahead and walk through this one pretty easily, right? Blast off the line of scrimmage. Get downfield to a certain point, usually around 8 to 10 yards. Turn around and make sure the quarterback sees your numbers and set yourself up for the pass.
A well-executed curl route by Charles Davis. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Out of the gun, Herbert. Incomplete, crisis averted. Almost picked. Instead, second down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
Under four to go now as they come up on second down. To throw again. Herbert. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of nine. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Those short little routes probably going to be open. The defense, they'll let those happen, especially when they can make an inbounds tackle.
Yeah, where's Coach Madden when you need him? He always talked about taking what the defense gives you, but sometimes you have to know when you have to take more. That was one of those situations.
He's got a man open. That's Allen. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. He's been big. Two touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here.
50-yard line.
From the 50, here's Herbert. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down L.A.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
On first down, it's Herbert. One's gone.
Intended for number 15.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Throwing again. Herbert. And that's into the hands of Eckler. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 21. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first. He's having a nice game through the air. His decision making's been really good. Solid there again. Just seeing nothing downfield goes underneath. Nice game.
How about the patience? Because when you're having a big game through the air, you're looking for those chunk plays, those big ones downfield. Instead, as you noted, takes the check down, dumps it off, gains good yardage anyway. Really well executed.
On first down, Justin Herbert. Flush to his right. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and seven.
And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. On second down, here's Herbert. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll wind up picking up about four, as that is going to bring us to the two-minute warning.
Four brings up third and three.
So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Meanwhile, third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Quick hands that time to knock that one away. It sure looked like a short touchdown, but able to get a good break on the football and force the incompletion.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now Herbert gives this one to Kelly. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the five. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
That was fourth and what we would call long in that situation, wasn't it? That wasn't fourth and inches, was it?
No, I mean, you get in those situations, fourth and three, fourth and four, that's a lot to, what would you say, a lot of pizza left in that box.
It certainly is. Not everyone dove in on that one.
In today's...
He's got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Chargers. Keenan Allen with a touchdown reception from Justin Herbert. And the Chargers are able to close the gap just a bit. Obviously, the scoreboard right now is not the friend of this rookie quarterback, but hey, a touchdown pass there maybe builds a little confidence.
Every rep is valuable when you're a rookie. Every time you step up and throw the football, there's a lesson to be learned. Yeah, he took advantage of a little bit of loose coverage there with the lead, but at the same time, got it done, and it'll take a little bit of satisfaction away from that throw.
A shotgun snap for Herbert, and this is complete. It's Allen.
Attempt at the two-point conversion is no good. That keeps the score.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
So it would no doubt be a miracle comeback from here, but let's see what they can do starting with the onside kick. And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job.
Tampa Bay.
Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's taken down inside the 30. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. This defense, Charles, they have unraveled here in the fourth.
In a sense, it's like they're being pressed like in a basketball game, and they just can't get the ball over half court. I mean, no matter what they do, they can't get off the field, they can't slow them down. They're just going up and down the field against them. Yeah, unraveling would be a perfect word for them.
Back to him on first down. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Kenneth Murray, the linebacker, there to make the play defensively. The 4-3 defense there did its job, funneled things right to the middle linebacker.
If they do a nice job of playing team defense, everyone takes care of their responsibilities, that allows that guy in the middle to do his job, which is search and destroy.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we say so long, everybody.
know my name. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains, I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls.